So here it is, guys. The year is over. We have all our comic book movies out. Justice League is out. So this is the sixth movie this year after Thor Ragnarok. We had six comic book movies. What a time to be alive. So let's rank them. Just so you know, these are my favorite, my personal opinions about these movies. They are not facts, they are just opinions. So if you disagree, hey, it's fine. No need to fight about it, right? So anyway, let's go. Number six, I'll put Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2. A movie I really enjoyed watching, but I didn't watch it more than twice because I thought the movie was trying too hard, but I still enjoyed it a lot. A lot of jokes didn't land for me. The story was just meh. It wasn't bad, but I liked the first Guardians of the Galaxy more. Actually, the first Guardians of the Galaxy is in my top 5 favorite MCU movies. So going into this movie, I was a bit disappointed, but I really enjoyed myself. I really liked the characters in this movie as always. So yeah, number five, I put Justice League. Yeah, Justice League was a great movie for me. Not a great movie, but a good movie, a really enjoyable one. It was really great to see all my favorite characters come together. I'm a big DC fan, big Superman fan, and they treat Superman really well in this movie. I really liked him, how they made it so powerful. It really was one of the most respectable incarnation of the character for me. So yeah, Justice League, number five for me. Number four, I'll put Thor Ragnarok. Thor Ragnarok, a really enjoyable time as well. Like I said, there are no bad movies this year. All the comic book movies were good. Thor Ragnarok is no exception. The movie was really fun. I was not on board with the funny Thor because, Thor is not supposed to be a comedian. But I was pretty open with Man of Steel, bringing some darkness to the interpretation of Superman. So, in the movies, it's really good to see some of the different sides of our favorite characters. So, it would be hypocritical for me not to be open to see a Thor that is a bit different if it helps, freshen the franchise. So, yeah, good thing. And also, the thing Thor Ragnarok did better than Guardians of the Galaxy was the jokes. I laughed a lot during this movie. And if you're sitting in the theater, you're laughing your ass off, and the fight sequences entertain you, then you're watching a great movie. Yeah, what can I say? I really liked Thor Ragnarok, and it was really, really fun. Number three, I put Spider-Man Homecoming. Spider-Man Homecoming was a great, great Spider-Man movie. But the best thing he did better than every movie in this list was the villain, Vulture. The Vulture was a really compelling villain. He was not evil just for the sake of being evil. No, he was stealing stuff from the alien invasion and trying to sell them just to make some money for his family, to provide for his family. It's not something you hate. It was not really evil. He wasn't really trying to kill anyone. He was just a thief. And Spider-Man is a street level superhero, so he has to stop him. And it was really good to see a superhero movie with no world ending consequences, just a grounded superhero movie that you can sit and just enjoy. I didn't like some part of the movie, like some high school students there that were not really comic accurate, but yeah, I can get past that, and I really, really enjoyed Spider-Man Homecoming in my top 3 of best Spider-Man movies ever made. Definitely, of course, you should check it out if you haven't seen it yet. Number 2 is my girl, Wonder Woman. Yeah, Wonder Woman surprised the shit out of me. I didn't go into this movie thinking, yeah, this is going to blow me away, but it did. Why? Because this movie could have easily fell in the trap of being feminist and too much on the nose feminist stuff, but I really walked out of the theater never thinking it was made for women or something like that. It was just a movie made for everyone. It was just a good movie with really great sequences and powerful dialogues and empowering themes. So it's a really step in the right direction for Hollywood. It really accomplished great things. I think they didn't really shine some light for Ares to shine, to be the villain could have been. But hey, we can get past that. The story was great. The action sequences were great. Gal Gadot nailed it. Patty Jenkins, well done. And number one, with no surprise, of course, is Logan. Logan is the best superhero movie of the year for me. No context, no competition. It's the first Wolverine movie I've liked. Maybe that's why I love it so much, because I was always like, hey, when are we going to get good Wolverine movie? And it was a shame because I really loved Hugh Jackman in the role, and I always thought he deserved better, but at least they gave him a good movie for him to go up with a bang. So there's that for him. So here are my lists. Do you agree with me? Do you disagree? Why? Let me know. As always, thank you for watching. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.